Dear friends, welcome back. This is the fourth video of the weather station, and as you can see, we are almost ready. We have implemented the weather station using an Arduino Pro Mini running at 8 MHz. We are using a BMP180 pressure sensor, a DHT22 humidity and temperature sensor. We are using an LDR for detecting night, and a Nokia 5110 LCD display. We are powering the project by 4 AA batteries. The total capacity of this power bank is about 2400 mAh, and with the code that it is running in the Arduino Pro Mini, we can have this project up and running for 33 days. The changes that we have made since the last video are those. First of all, we have replaced the Arduino Mega with this Arduino Pro Mini. This Arduino Mega runs in 16 MHz and it draws a lot of power, not just because of the frequency, but because it has a lot of other components that draw current. We don't need anything else. We are very happy with this little Arduino Pro Mini, and so we can move to this little one. Okay, this runs at 8 MHz. We are powering it at the raw pin because we are having almost stable voltage of around 5 volts with those batteries. And we have implemented a sleep method in order to sleep when we are not sensing the environment. So we are now measuring temperature every 2 minutes. Every 2 minutes we sense temperature, humidity and pressure. And while we are not sensing, we sleep. So let's see how much current it draws right now. Okay, Arduino is now sleeping and the backlight is on. So as you can see, it draws around 26 milliamps, pretty much. Now, if we disable the backlight, as you can see, the current draw drops to 3 milliamps, almost 3 milliamps, very nice. So when Arduino is sleeping, it draws nothing, almost 3 milliamps. And when Arduino is sensing the environment, it reads temperature, humidity and pressure, this current draw rises up to 7 or 8 milliamps. We'll see that in a second. Okay, Arduino is now sensing the environment. I made the delay to be 10 seconds in order to be able to watch it. But in normal circumstances, it will only sensing the environment for 2 seconds. So, it sleeps for 2 minutes. It draws 3 milliamps when it is sleeping. And it draws 7 milliamps for 2 seconds every 2 minutes in order to display the results in the screen. Okay, we now have covered the LDR sensor. In order to emulate night. So now Arduino thinks that it is night and it has disabled the LCD screen. So now the current draw is 2.81 milliamps. We are down around 25 milliamps since we had the LCD screen on. If we remove the cover, it will take up to 2 minutes to update the reading from the LDR sensor, so we have to wait a bit in order the screen to come back and see how much current it draws when the screen is on. Okay, now measuring for 10 seconds in order to be able to see exactly the current draw, and now we are back to 3 milliamps current draw. That's it, very convenient. So we have also removed the LED from the Arduino Pro Mini because it draws power. Let's talk about the connections with the Arduino Mini. The LCD screen is connected through the digital pins here. The BMP sensor is connected via the I2C interface wires, which are those one here. The DHT11 pin is connected to pin 4, digital pin 4. The LDR is powered only when sensing the environment. because it draws current. So when every 2 minutes we enable the LDR, we sense the environment via analog pin 1, and then we disable it. That's why we have connected the power pin. This orange wire goes to digital pin 3. We enable power to the LDR, we measure current, we measure light intensity, and then we disable it, because it draws current all the time if we have connected it to the VCC. And lastly, we have connected ground and raw pins. I have also soldered these female header pins here in order to be easy to program the Arduino with an FTDI device. That's it. Let's see the code. First of all, we have to download the low power library for Arduino. This is the website, the GitHub repository, in which you can find the library. You can find the link for the library in the description of the video. You click here and download zip, and you download the library. We now unzip it. Let's unzip it in the desktop, rename it low power, for example. Okay, now cut. Documents, Arduino libraries, paste. Okay, that's it. Now let's see the code. First of all, we have to include a new library. This is the low power library, in order to put Arduino in sleep. Next, we have changed all the pins for the sensors, because we are now using the Arduino Pro Mini, and so it has fewer pins than the Arduino Mega. So we have made some changes here. DHT pin now for the DHT sensor is pin number 4, digital pin number 4. Digital pins 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 are used for the LCD. Digital pin number 3 is used for the LDR power, because we power on the LDR sensor only when we are reading the value. And LDR pin, the analog read, is pin number 1. When we read the value of the light sensor, it's connected to pin, the analog pin number 1. Okay, setup function is the same. We only have to do is to declare the output pin for the LDR power. Okay, next. Now, this is a little change. When we start the loop, we read the light intensity. We enable the power to the LDR. We sleep for a little bit in order the value to be stable, the value of the light intensity that it reads, and we read the light intensity. And then we disable the digital pin. We don't need it anymore. Then, if it is night, if the light density is below 10, we disable the LCD screen and we sleep for 2 minutes. We don't have to measure temperature or humidity, because it's just waste of time and energy for the batteries. We just sleep, and in 2 minutes we check back if the light is greater than 10. So if light is very low, if it's below 10, we sleep. Else, we turn the screen back on if it is off, and we read the sensor. We print them in the screen, and lastly, we sleep again for 2 minutes. This is a new function that sleeps the Arduino, that puts Arduino in sleep for 2 minutes. It's only a for loop and a low power down function from the library, the low power library that we included. This line here puts Arduino in sleep for 8 minutes. So we put it in a for loop for 15 times and we sleep for 2 minutes. So the code is very similar to the previous one. The only thing we do is we add the sleep function. Very easy. The code is you can find the code in the description of the video. If you have any question, please comment and I'll answer you back. The cost of this project is very low. If we are using the DHT11 sensor instead of the expensive DHT22 sensor, we can have the cost of this project down to 9 euros. Let's see. 2 euros for the LCD display. 1.70 euro for the Arduino Pro Mini 8 MHz. Around 2 euros for the BMP180 and 2 euros for the DHT11. So the cost is around 7 or 8 euros and 1 euro for the battery holder, we are up to 9 euros. So the batteries of the power bank are more expensive than the project itself. It's very low cost, and if we want to have more accuracy, we can add 5 euros to the project in order to replace this sensor here with this better one. We are up to around 15 euros. It's pretty impressive what we can do with very cheap electronics these days. So the future of this project is to add a simple push button in order to have different modes in the display, so we can display pressure history, temperature history or humidity history. Of course, it is very easy to add a simple SD card in order to log the readings. A real-time clock will be nice, or even Ethernet capability, but more in the future videos. Thank you very much for watching. Please like if you liked the video or subscribe to our channel to watch our next videos. Thank you very much.